Dave, do you remember when you went to school in the middle of the week, your teacher get up and say, now, on Friday, we're going to have a test. And I just want to share with you some of the questions that are going to be on the test, and I want to get you ready. Mm-hmm. If you'll read these pages and if you'll know these answers to these questions, you're going to do real good on the test. And comes Friday, sure enough, the questions she talked about, the pages you needed to read, they're all out in front of you. What that teacher was really trying to do was set you up for success. She knew, he knew, the test was coming on Friday, and they also knew what the questions were going to be, so they said, we want you on the front end to get you prepared so that you can do well when you take the test. Well, this book asks 10 questions that any person who wants to pursue their dream should ask themselves, and I'm the teacher. And I'm pretty well putting this book in people's hands, and I'm saying, you're going to be tested in your dream. Dreams aren't free. And so therefore, since you're going to be tested, let me give you the questions that you need to know and get those answers so that as you pursue your dream, you're not taken by surprise. You're not blindsided. You're saying, oh, you know, John said this was going to come up. And you can know the questions before you ever start the test journey. And it just is a phenomenal concept. And it's just been out for a very short time, but the response is already huge because people tell me many times that they go into their dream totally unprepared. That, you know, I've got a dream and I'm not sure how it's going to evolve, and I'm not sure exactly even what it is, but I sure have this dream. And it's really kind of like a crapshoot. This really kind of helps a person streamline their thinking and their strategy so that they really can pursue that dream effectively. Dreams give people hope. Mm. I can tell you that dreams give people hope. That's the positive side. And nothing probably has people frustrated or disappointed more than dreams. Dreams give hope, and yet most people in that hope get highly disappointed. It's kind of like you define disappointment as the gap between expectation and reality. Mm-hmm. That's what disappointment is. And in dreams, you have this expectation, but you often get reality. Mm-hmm. And it's that gap between them that causes them to be disappointed. So when I wrote the book, I began to ask myself, how can I help them bridge the gap? How can I help them to get from reality to expectation? If we can close that gap, there are going to be a lot more people that have hope and a lot more people that won't be disappointed. Mm-hmm. And so that's kind of where I started heading. And I came up with the conclusion, which really is like the thesis of the book, Dave, that the more valid reasons a person has to achieve their dream, the higher the odds are that they will. Hmm. And if I have only one valid reason, let's say I have a dream, and I only have one real good reason to do this, because the dream journey is very difficult and it's very steep and there's just a cost questions and all kind of issues, if I only have one reason to kind of hang on to that dream, it's probable that I'll quit and never achieve it. But let's say I have 7 reasons. I mean, they're valid reasons for me to receive and achieve this dream. Now, I mean, I'll get some stuff knocked out of me, and I might lay aside a couple of them, but it's hard to lay aside 7 good, solid reasons. And so the whole issue is most people don't achieve their dream. I don't think because it's not necessarily a valid dream. They don't achieve their dream because they have never discovered the right reasons to achieve that dream. And the valid reasons that we have, which increases the odds of achieving the dream, I turned into the 10 questions. Mm. So when I started this book, I said, how many valid reasons are there to achieve a dream? And I just went wild. I just kept writing and writing like you would in a kind of a creative sense. I got 33. And then I began to reduce those valid reasons down to 10. And when I got the 10 valid reasons for achieving a dream, I put those reasons in the form of questions. Mm-hmm. And that's, so the questions substantiate the thesis. The thesis is the more valid reasons you have to achieve your dream, the higher the odds are that you will.